All right, let's talk about the very basics for how to open and format a document to sell as a printable online. So here's my Etsy printables shop. You can see I sell tons of different types of printables, but they all start exactly the same way, and that's in my favorite design software, Affinity Designer. Here's an example of a printable that has lots of pages, and so you can see I use a lot of different art boards, but let's create a new document for your printable. So I'm gonna just do new document. I'm in the US, so we print on regular letter size paper. That's 8.5 by 11 inches. I'm keeping the DPI at 300. I like to work with art boards, so I'm gonna create an art board. Here's an important step. The color format should be CMYK because home printing will be done on a home printer that uses cyan, magenta, yellow, and K for black ink. CMYK is for printed materials. RGB is for digital items. RGB has a much wider color palette because, of course, colors on a screen are backlit. You can get a lot of different range of colors. CMYK is a more limited palette, and you want to make sure that you have that set for your printables. I like to have a transparent background. I set all my margins to 1/4 inch on all four sides for my printables. Now, the only thing you may run into is some home printers have a default bottom margin of 1/2 inch. So if a customer ever messages you and says that your documents are getting cut off at the bottom, tell them to go into their printer margins and see if that bottom margin is set to 1/2 inch. I like to have all my margins at 1/4 inch because that keeps everything nice and even. So let's say we are just gonna make an amazing printable. Obviously, we are never gonna sell a document that just says the words amazing printables, but for the sake of this tutorial, you're gonna create your beautiful printable, right? I don't know what it's gonna look like. I don't know what you're making. Maybe we want the words to be pink. But once you get all your design elements on there, you can set it up. Here, let's put a nice heart so it isn't just text, right? You're gonna make whatever it is you're selling to people. Get all your elements on there. And now it's time to save it. So before I export, actually I should always save in the beginning. Before you export to save, there's something I want you to start including in every document you sell, and that's a terms of use page. I'm gonna copy and paste this artboard in here. I don't do this for all my printables. I just have this PDF saved, and then I drop this page into all the PDFs I create for my printables. But you should have a terms of use page. Mine thanks people for their purchase, asks them to review their purchase. Nobody reviews. It's so hard to get people to review. Every review helps. And then I have the terms of use. Your terms are gonna say whatever it is you want them to say. Mine say this product is to be used by the original customer only. You cannot copy it, you cannot display it, you cannot distribute it digitally. This is intended for classroom or personal use. I do not sell commercial, I don't sell any of my files for commercial use, so that's why it says commercial use is prohibited. Your purchase constitutes agreement to these terms. And then how can you use this item? For my digital printables, I just say print as many copies as you'd like for personal or classroom use, but do not share the electronic file. Then I have my little logo here, my information, and my website. Now, do I think that nobody will ever violate the terms of use? No, people violate it, but truly the majority of your customers are going to be amazing people who do not violate your terms of use, and it's nice to just have it there to remind them of it. So now, once your printable is ready to go, you're gonna go to File, Export, and there's a lot of discussion in my like printable sellers groups online about this, but as a commercial printer myself, I print wide format posters. I cannot stress enough how easy and ideal it is to save everything in a PDF, okay? Some people save as JPEGs. Your JPEG might reset to a much larger size, so then it isn't the ideal size for your customer to print. If you print in a PDF, and if you have your document formatted as a letter size document, Then it's just going to make the printing process much easier for your end user, which is your customer, and you want your customer to have the easiest possible time printing your work. So I would select PDF. And then it might show up, PDF for print might be the first thing that populates, but you want to pull it down to PDF flatten. If you keep it at PDF for print, your individual elements in your download are going to be accessible to your customer. This is particularly problematic if you're using artwork that you purchase the commercial rights to use in your printables. You cannot allow your customers to have access to those elements in the final file. It has to be flattened. So flatten it, and then it will just be a flat image. You can't, nobody can pull out the different elements. I want the whole area to export. I'm gonna export this. Here's my printables demo. And now, look, I have this beautiful, amazing printable to upload to my Etsy. This is a PDF, you're just gonna close it, save it to your computer, whatever platform you're selling on, this is what you would upload, and then your customers would get a download. And you can see, since we flattened it, I am not able to highlight just the text here or any of these elements, which is exactly what you want. You just want everyone to only get a flat image of your final product. All right, I can't wait to see what you create. Have fun, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.